Our next session brings together two wonderfully talented women in balancing life and work, then and now. Veteran Bollywood actor with 60 films and several classic hits to her name, Sharmila Tagore led the Indian Film Censor Board from 2004 to 2011. In December 2005, she was chosen UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador to raise awareness of the impact of AIDS on children. In 2013, she received the Padma Bhushan. Soha Ali Khan is the youngest daughter of Sharmila and legendary cricketer Mansoor Ali Khan Patodi. She is a rising Bollywood actor with 25 films to her credit. 2017 has seen two milestones in her life: the birth of her daughter Inaya and the launch of her first book, a marvelous read, The Perils of Being Moderately Famous. I'm delighted to welcome on stage the talented mother-daughter duo, Sharmila Tagore and Soha Ali Khan. Sharmila ji, Soha,
hi.
Welcome. Delighted to have you here. There has been much talk today about women achievers in every field, entrepreneurs, politics, gender. And to begin with, I just want to say, Sharmila ji, of course, I'm a huge fan of your work, but I'm a far greater fan of both your children, Soha and Saif. You began acting at a very young age. You started your career as a child, almost. And you went on to work through your marriage, after having children. How did you balance the roles that you had to play? Because work was always a part of your life from a very young age. You never gave that up.
You know, I really hoped that there would be more men in the audience.
Room?
Yes, I don't think we can only talk about women, because men have to listen to us,
they have to be
and
part
we have
of that
to listen
journey.
To them.
Yes.
Don't you agree? I think so, yeah. So next time you should have more men.
Okay.
Working then, well, actually getting married, nothing changed very much, because I was working before, then I met Tiger, and we were living together. So I was working and he was playing cricket and we were making time. But when you get married, it is really a commitment to spend more time with each other. So it's a division of 24 hours again.
But even when you got married, I think you pushed the boundary. I mean, he was from a different community. He was a cricketer. Suddenly I'm thinking of Grace Kelly and Anushka and Virat. When I think of your story, these are the images and the people that I remember. Because you chose to do something that most leading actresses and Bollywood heroines would never have thought to do. And you were also the wife of the Nawab of Patodi. That was a different kind of role. So balancing all those different
roles.
Well,
you know, I always heard my body clock. If I wanted to do something, being an actor also, there is timing in your life. And I wanted to be married at a certain age. I wanted to have children at a certain age. I didn't want to wait too long for it, you know. I wanted to do this while I was still young. So I managed to do that. And I didn't want to give up work, so I carried on working.
And balancing all of it seems to have been effortless for you.
Well, I don't know how you see it now after so many years. It was, again, as I said, it is a division of 24 hours.
Yeah.
When your family grows, you have a husband first, then you have children. So you have to find time for everything.
Today,
and it's not difficult.
Well,
I think when you want something, when you really want something, you manage to do it.
Do you think that today, being an actor, Soha, your personal life is constantly under scrutiny? I think even more so today, because of social media, because of, you know, the access one has to an actor's life. How difficult is it for you to balance? You've just had a baby. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And I I want to congratulate you also on your book. It was a marvelous read.
Thank you. Thank you.
Very funny, very honest. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Do you think in this, at this time, it's harder than it was in your mom's time to balance everything?
I think, as Amma said, it's about priorities, and it's impossible to do everything. But as Amma said, if you want to continue working, and I wanted to after I got married, after I had Inaya, I still have a lot that I want to accomplish in my own personal professional life. You have to create a certain infrastructure at home that has to continue even after you're gone, even when you're not at home.
Does that infrastructure include the husband?
That infrastructure, the husband is instrumental. And I'm glad, I think that at least when it comes to, we may be a minority, but at least when it comes to my friends and certainly my life, husbands are becoming more and more supportive and aware that parenting is a two-person job. So I can certainly say that. And in terms of then and now, I remember my father actually being at home more than Amma was working more, because her career continued long after my father's, him being a professional athlete. By the time I was born, he had retired. And, my memories of him are him always being at home on the takht and reading books and spending lots of time with us, helping us do our homework, writing our school debates. Sometimes he would be perplexed by whether I was allowed to wax my legs or, if I was allowed to stay the night at Priyanka's house, and then he would have to call Amma, who was, for instance, shooting for Mississippi Masala, and she had to go away for 3 months at that time, and, we were very upset. And then, but I also understood. I grew up watching my mother going to work, and, I understood. So it was different for me growing up in terms of Abba being more at home and Amma going to work, but she would make an effort. And if she wasn't there for our birthdays, then we would celebrate our birthday when she was around. And it wasn't as, of course she must have, I'm assuming, felt a certain amount of guilt, missed out on a few things.
No, I don't know. I don't think I would call it guilt. Again, no, it's,
as
it's,
you shouldn't.
It's all right. You can't base your life on guilt. Yeah. I think I was able to, at least I tried to teach the girls and my children to value a woman's work. And I taught them to say, get 10 on 10 when I was going out to work. Because they understood that. And because although they were central to our lives, but they also had to respect our time and our solo time, which I think I was able to manage. And they were very proud of the fact that, my mother was going out to work.
Do you have any regrets? Like you said, we talked a lot about guilt in the previous panel and about how women are managing guilt, in the workplace and at home. So I think this is something actually I resonate with, Sharmila ji, because my mother says the same, that, I feel no guilt whatsoever. So did you have any regrets that you, because of your professional commitments, that you would have done something differently, that you could have done something
differently? I was never ready to give up work. At the same time, I wanted a family and I wanted children, because I grew up in a joint family and I couldn't imagine a life without children. I didn't want to be only a career person. And I wanted to do this when I was in my 20s and not when I was in my 40s. So, yes, I mean, it was difficult. And this was, you were just asking Soha whether it's easier now. I would say it's so much easier because you have a cell phone, which we didn't have. I remember trying, and Tiger used to travel when he went to Australia. It took him 6 months to return, because they had to go to New Zealand after that. And if I had to call him, I had to call him at 1 o'clock at night, in the morning. And getting a telephone was so difficult. I didn't have a phone, so I had to go to a friend's house at 1:30, a man friend's house at 1:30 at night. And every time the phone rang, I had to book a lightning call, and it wasn't lightning. And I had to pick up the phone, and the other person at the other end would say, who's this woman in this man's house, and quickly put the phone down. And then the call had to go via London. So that's how,
difficult.
So we had to write, letters used to take, and now you have Skype, your communication, your transport, everything is
not
so much better.
You still don't know how to use Skype, though.
Yeah,
so Amma's still of that generation.
But yes, so it's so much easier. And talking about guilt, I don't think I have so much guilt because I did whatever I could do. I know that I've done my best. I've tried to be around when they needed me. in their special concert days or wherever, you know. But I also had to go to work, and I also, and then Tiger very happily stayed back with them. And because we didn't have, my mother-in-law was not in Bombay, my mother was not in Bombay, they were not prepared to leave their homes and come and babysit. So it was Tiger and I, and we managed.
So that's a very important point, that that unit, your partner and you, forms that unit.
Absolutely. And it's not necessary that he has to change the diapers or he has to do whatever. It's while I'm doing something, if the telephone needs answering, or something, marriage has to be attended to. I mean, he can do that. So it's a sharing of chores, and not what he thinks that he needs to do, but help me around, you know, in doing what I'm doing.
I think that's very encouraging at that time, if you were able to, you know, sort of keep those gender roles sort of flexible, because there's a lot of talk about that as well today, throughout the day. You know, we come from a profession, your industry is one where you are, there's an image, there's a public image and there's a private self. So balancing even that is kind of tricky. But when you are very comfortable with what that those images are, it becomes easier. And I think gender roles is a very important part of how you have chosen to live your life. I think especially you, and maybe by example Soha as well, from a very young age when you first came to Bombay, you did as you pleased. You know, you lived in a way that you pleased. You
see, there are so many people out there. I can't please everybody. I have to live according to my own priorities. If I try to please you or please you or please him, then it's really not possible. So when the children arrive, so you have to divide your time between the children, your you know, you have to prioritize. And then your work. Then you can't go to a party, for instance. I didn't go to premieres. Because thank God we didn't have to promote films as they have to do now. So, yeah, and the social media wasn't there. Yeah. So that pressure wasn't there, but we had to attend premieres. So I didn't do that. I didn't do a lot of interviews because that took time. So I opted out of a lot of time-consuming things, which was not not relevant to me.
Soha, do you think those are choices that you still have?
Yes, again, you constantly have to choose. I think the ideas that I've strongly believed in, because I've seen this growing up, that a woman can do everything, and you can't do everything at the same time, but you can certainly achieve your professional and your personal dreams if you have support. And you require support from the people who employ you. You require support from your family and your domestic environment. So, of course, if you're married, you need a supportive husband, which I'm fortunate to have. If a lot of people, including myself, have moved away from their family homes and they live in cities, they live in these no longer in joint families, so you can't rely on family to assist you when you're working. Your husband is also working, so where possible, you employ a caregiver. You know, so you have that infrastructure. Your employers need to be sensitive to that as well and help you. So if women have the support that we require, then it's possible to...
That's a very important point, I think, because it's about prioritizing, not really equal time to everything, but prioritizing what there is, as you said, you know, the 24 hours in a day. But also this point about, I think, for young women who want to get into this business and who want to sort of have, there's no real magic formula. You know, there is a lot of stuff that goes into especially a creative field. What is the one piece of advice that you feel that will help them, in addition to having a support system, which I think is something that has become very clear this whole day, about managing to balance and yet pursue their dreams? Is it following the inner voice, as you said, Sharmila ji?
You have to be very honest with yourself. At the end of the day, what do you want? It is your decision to get married. It's your decision to have children. It's your decision to work. And you know, at least in our profession, it's not very... the demand is not very considerate, because if you get stuck, say the last shot is taking time and the camera is not working, you have to extend, because you know a lot of money is invested in that. So in my time, we were working in 2, 3, 4 films at a time. At least they're working in one film at a time. So the industry has become far more considerate.
Yes.
Earlier, it was far more difficult. But having said that, what I have decided, I should be able to fulfill. And as Soha said, you need a supporting environment at home, so you must get people who can help you. If not the extended family and the husband, you have somebody who's there. And now you can phone and you can ring up and you can have what? CCTV in every room so that you can check
on
them.
In every room.
Yes. Yeah.
Well, there is something that I wanted to touch upon about motherhood, since I have a mother-daughter duo on this stage with me, people who I admire very much. How does that really add to this idea of being a woman, really? You said, you know, your choices are your choices. But when you become a mother, do those choices change? Does life really change? And we touched upon a lot of that today as well. And how does that really interfere with your, whatever choices you may have had when you were growing up?
I wouldn't say changes. I mean, of course it changes. Life changes. I mean, I had black hair, now I have gray hair. Things change and my perception changes. As I grow older, I imbibe much more. I understand. You understand that.
But in,
so you will.
In our profession also, I feel you're scrutinized when you become a mother. Soha, did you feel any of that?
You know, I... No, quickly, to say that scrutinized, yes. I mean, you should be so conscious about what other people are thinking of you.
I think yes. I think there is a certain, of course, now with social media being so prevalent, it's a good thing and a bad thing. I think people are seeing women as they really are. Sometimes when you're just going to the doctors, you're going to the gym, you know, no makeup looks, and, you know, so people see you as opposed to, you know, on screen as a finished product, you know, if you will. And I think they understand now that actors are also real people going about doing real things, and you know, are you nodding? Are you shaking your head?
Shaking ahead.
Yeah. Imperceptibly, you're shaking your head.
You know, there is a certain kind of expectation that people have. Although they know they're real people, but they kind of suspend that, you know.
But I think
and
now...
You still have to give in to their expectation of what they think of you. But as I was saying, that if you live like that, then somehow what happens to your own life? So you have to prioritize
and you can't please
somewhere
everyone else.
Your own wishes. Rather than just live to, you know, what... And everybody will accept you in the long run. Your image builds up, you know, five minutes at a time. And in this long life I've had, when I came to Bombay and I wasn't chaperoned, I was living alone, I used to have the odd drink and the odd cigarette, I used to wear hipsters, the bikini photograph, and all those things happened. And then people were speculating, saying things... But over the long years, today, their perception of me is different. My perception of myself is different. I have grown up. I have taken on, you know, like a tree that has grown. And I'm enjoying that. But it happened then. You have to choose what you want to do. And if you choose, if you marry for lust, that's what you'll get. If you marry for money, that's what you'll get. If you marry for love, that's what you'll get. But you can't marry for lust and then say, I married for love and that's why my marriage didn't work.
Yeah.
So you have to be very honest with yourself.
I think that's beautiful. That's beautifully put. I think the two takeaways, Soha, you wanted to say something?
No, of course not. No.
I think the two takeaways that I got most of all is actually just being sort of true to yourself and being responsible for your choices, because as you said, I think...
Yes, and I think women are becoming more and more courageous and they are being true to themselves and they're embracing that aspect of their identity, and those are good role models, because I think when you, even if your life is comfortable, if you fight for someone else whose life is not comfortable, it gives them the courage to speak up for themselves. So even though my life may be privileged, I can still represent someone else and try and make their lives easier. And then the idea is, of course, as Amma said, that's why we want to see more men, is for men to be supportive of that and not to be scared of the empowered women, or not to, you know, regret that, but to sort of celebrate that and embrace that.
And sooner that happens, it'll be so much better.
Hopefully it's happening starting today.
Yes,
thank
absolutely.
Thank you, Sharmila ji and Soha. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having us.